Should we adjust it slightly? Tigran, so we're ready when you are. All right, guys. Hi, everyone. Let's have everyone introduce themselves. Hi, my name is Kirill Listanovich, and I'm the head of marketing at Strikers, Inc. I'm responsible for our promotion marketing. I'm Maxim Chinega, the CTO on Strikers, Inc. I look after all the technical stuff and everything related, from animation system to back-end and all possible infrastructure issues. Hello, I'm Eugene, the CEO at Strikers. Among other things, I'm responsible for the product and all the strategic stuff we do. My name is Tigran. I'm a director of the brand new Developers Diaries. Today, I'd like to discuss the new Dev Diaries format. Why do we need to change it at all? What was wrong with the old standard one? We suddenly realized one thing. When we started making Dev Diaries for the first time, the production quality was pretty good, and we thought it looked fun. We spent an incredible amount of time making it. We created a perfect flow, wrote a detailed script. The team wrote down their answers before filming, and of course, this made everything look quite unnatural. The end result felt more like a short trailer rather than a developer's diary story. It didn't give you any insight into the development process. But we wanted to show the reality, where we're at. Is it on already? And I can... Currently, our team implements dummies in the game. We're adding additional features to the process of dribbling to make it more fun for our players. And we're conscious of making it as responsive and clear as possible. We want the models to move in the way a user would expect them to. Yes, it's a rainbow flick. But you can see here in the rainbow, there's an issue with the ball. So we're working to make the ball trajectory more realistic. And do you have a list of tricks that you want to include? Sure thing, there's a list. In an ideal world, how many of them do you want or need? I'm not sure about the number. It's in the docs, but I think we're aiming for around 20 of them. And so what did you decide to do? What do you want the Dev Diaries to show in an ideal world? How do you imagine it? Well, the main task is perhaps to show the core, the very essence of the production processes of working on the UFL. We needed some intimate glimpses into our process and to keep them as honest as possible. In line with our fair-to-play philosophy. And that's the general vision of what we want to achieve with this project along this journey. You mentioned journey. Yes. Is this the title for the project then? If so, why is it Journey and what does that represent? We've called it Journey because it's our voyage towards the UFL launch from our current stage, starting from today at the beginning of May. And it's no doubt a thorny path because there's still a lot of work to do. We understand that if we promote the product the ordinary, standard way, well, our audience won't be excited. We have to show something bigger and fresher, make it a series. And we travel along this series from episode to episode, as you would a journey. Here are a couple of examples. Some have been implemented, some are yet to be introduced into the build. Currently, our interface has some placeholders. We added them to the project so we could see how it would feel and work in the game. For example, here is the qualification screen. A player gets sent here right after club creation. You can see they have to play through some qualification matches and then are finally promoted into higher division. So what's next then? What's our path, our journey? We have a roadmap for the upcoming months. 6 episodes. And this will be the first season in our series. We'll show the key moments of a game's production process. Most of the topics cover gameplay, either core or meta. So every episode is centered around one or another aspect. From stadium creation, core gameplay mechanics, how the game works, how it's related to the animation system, how game systems interact, how the game design affects them. And definitely on the list is AI. We've got two of them. The first one assists the player and controls the rest of your team while you're focusing on one particular footballer. The second one is a bot that runs independently and controls the whole team without any help from a player. Also, in one of the episodes, we discuss everything related to our visual style, why we chose it, how we developed it and such. Besides, there probably should be something about the real-life events we take part in. And the final episode of this series will be dedicated to the game launch. The first one will be our concept arena, Rodenta Stadium. It's been ready for a long time now, but we're still polishing it, adding more tiny details and breathing life into it. The stadium is beautiful, and it's pretty much how we wanted it to be. How much are we allowed to show? Any parts of the gameplay? Yes, I think there will be lots of mechanic stuff and core gameplay from different angles. We'll show both our strengths and flaws and what we've done to have them fixed, how the game has changed for the better. I would add another point here. There are some legal restrictions on what we can and can't show. Our audience often ask questions we have answers for, but we can't say a word because of the legal issues. Sometimes we don't have the permission to use an asset outside of the game, or it's somehow connected with our partnerships. It's a delicate matter when it comes to licensing. For each licensing asset, we need a special permission. Actually, the licensing is a really interesting and complicated matter we're dealing with quite successfully so far. Okay, that's what I do. My job is to adjust the motion dynamics of objects in our game. And right now I'm setting up to adjust character movement. What I try to do here is highlight the areas I want to improve, making the character movement as anatomically accurate as it can possibly be. As you can see, right now, our puppet's body slightly waves. A real person walks in a somewhat different way, and everyone would notice it, even if it's hard to explain what's actually wrong. So I'm adjusting the settings to make the movements more natural. We work on collisions, simulating various situations which may happen on the pitch and then evaluating them closely. And how do you know it isn't working? It's mostly done by watching. Sometimes you see the body looks unnatural. The limbs aren't behaving correctly. Can someone who watches our journey affect the series? Do you plan to interact with your audience and let those conversations inform the content? The first thing we did when we announced the game was launch our official social media, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. And there's a huge audience there. They follow the project, share their feedback, and support us. We plan to post dev diaries on YouTube and collect feedback through our official channels. Right now, we're testing corner kicks. We initialize the kick, and you can see how the players take their places, and if they take their places correctly. How do you know something's wrong? We can always tell what's a bug, and we have some set indicators for that. We mentioned that a game designer is a person who knows how things are supposed to be working in the game, but when you see a clash of five footballers at the same place, it's quite obvious to anyone that something went wrong.
Houston, we have a problem.
And let's have a look at how corners work with AI bots, what they do and how they play. Across now. Keep it. Dang, he pushed him. He did. Cool. Thanks, guys. You're welcome. Why do you think anyone might be interested in the series? Right now, at this point, we can't say 100%. It's an experiment to some extent, and a risky one. But we do hope the audience will grab the chance to get such unfiltered, uncensored information as it is, with comments on what's happening. Because we, on our side, are really interested in interacting with our audience. We'd love to build these relationships to the extent where, after we've done something, we collect feedback, show some gameplay, explain what's happening, and get some more feedback again. If people like it, awesome, then we're doing it right. And if people don't like this format of diaries, we'll keep on experimenting. We need a way to present the info in a way our audience would like and we would be able to easily create, whilst also keeping the overall quality of the assets. Yeah, that's right. Everything Eugene has just mentioned is to help our audience build confidence in our product. And the last question, I know you'll ask me to cut it away. Guys, what is the launch date? We're looking to announce a release date this August. I hope the new series will help the audience to understand why this can be so hard to pin down. We'd better show the weaker sides of the game, so when it's released, they say, wow, what an improvement. Actually, there is a playable, mostly functional build. Everyone in the studio plays it. Yeah, we have weekly playtests on a regular basis. But there's still a lot to polish. We understand what the audience wants, and we'd love to show it off. You know, we'd hate to put out semi-fake, nicely polished development videos just because we want to make an impression, without considering the fact that everything's under construction. It often happens in game development, that materials are quickly polished and shown to the public that are still raw, unfinished, or don't even make it into the final game. The promotional videos look amazing, and then you run the game and you're like, oh, when I watch their promos, the game looked quite different. We don't want to go this way, because it doesn't make any sense. Yes, it might grow hype, but it also creates immense disappointment. That's not the way we want to go. The most important thing I'd like to say now is that all the team is super incentivized to make our plans come true. And we will do everything to reach that goal. Great. Thanks a lot. Thank you, Tigre. Talk to you later. See you all, guys. Thanks.
Welcome.